क्लास 11th सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स फोर्थ चैप्टर लॉज ऑफ मोशन फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर लेट अस सी कंजर्वेटिव एंड नॉन कंजर्वेटिव फोर्सेस. सो लेट अस सी व्हाट आर द कंजर्वेटिव एंड नॉन कंजर्वेटिव फोर्सेस. द वर्क डन बाय फोर्स एफ इन मूविंग एन ऑब्जेक्ट थ्रू ए डिस्टेंस dx is given as the scalar product of force and the displacement. So the work done dw due to the force F which moves that object through distance dx is given as dw equal to vector F dot vector dx, that is the scalar product of force and the displacement, which is nothing but minus du, that is the negative work done. Or from this we can write the work done du, that is the energy. Work done is nothing but the energy, that is the change in energy. Dw is equal to minus F into dx. So this will be the change in energy. This negative sign will indicate that there will be decrease in the energy, and therefore du is equal to minus F into dx, which is similar to that of dw, that is the work done. Now if the work done by or against a force is independent of the actual path followed by the object, then the force is said to be conservative force. If the work done by or against a force is independent of the actual path followed by that object, then the force is said to be conservative force. For example, when an object lying on the ground is lifted up and kept on the table. Suppose there is any object which is initially lying on the ground, then we have picked it up or we have lifted it and kept on the table at some height. During this process, the amount of work done is against gravitational force, because gravitational force will be directed towards the ground, that is in the downward direction, and we are lifting that object in the upward direction, and therefore we can say that during lifting process of this object from the ground to the surface of the table, in this process the amount of work done is against gravitational force. Now if the air resistance, that is opposition exerted by the air, if that air resistance is neglected, then the work done will be independent of the path followed by the object when it is placed on the surface of the table or on the ground. That means when that object is lifted up and kept on the table surface by any path, and again if that object is now placed on the ground from the surface of the table by any other path, then for both these path followed by that object, the work done will be independent of the path followed, because in this case only conservative force, that is gravitational force, is acting on it and the air resistance is neglected, and hence this will represent the example of the conservative force, and hence here the gravitational force will be considered as the conservative force. During the work done by a conservative force, during the work done by a conservative force, the mechanical energy, that is the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy, is conserved. So some part of kinetic energy will get converted into पोटेंशियल एनर्जी और सम पार्ट ऑफ पोटेंशियल एनर्जी विल गेट कन्वर्टेड इन टू काइनेटिक एनर्जी, बट एट लास्ट द मेकैनिकल एनर्जी दैट इज सम ऑफ काइनेटिक एनर्जी एंड पोटेंशियल एनर्जी टुगेदर विल बी कॉन्जर्व विल रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट. देन द वर्क डन बाय और अगेंस्ट कॉन्जर्वेटिव फोर्सेस appears as an equal amount of change in potential energy. The work done by or against conservative forces reflect an equal amount of change in potential energy, and the corresponding work done is used in changing the position of the object. The corresponding work done, that is change in energy, will be used for changing the position of the object, and hence the potential energy is always called as energy possessed by that object on account of position. So potential energy of any object is always related with the position of that object. On the other hand, if the work done by or against the force depends upon the actual path followed. If that work done by or against the force depends upon the actual path followed by that object, then the force is said to be non-conservative force. If that work done depends upon the path followed by the body, then that force will be said to be non-conservative force. For example, again, in the same example as that of the conservative forces, if you consider an object lying on the ground and lifted it and kept on the surface of the table, but in this case the air resistance will be present. In case of concept of conservative forces, the air resistance was neglected, but in case of non-conservative forces now, the air resistance is present. Then at that time, the force of friction, the air drag, so like these forces are now acting on that body, and these forces are the non-conservative forces. Because in this case, the path followed will be different for different cases, and hence for these different paths, the different work done will be there. That is, work done will depend upon the path followed. As per different paths, the work done will be different, and hence such forces like force of friction or air drag, that is air resistance, these are nothing but the non-conservative forces. Now the work done against these non-conservative forces appears in the form of heat energy, sound energy, or light energy. So this work done against these forces will appear in the form of heat, sound, or light, and the work done against the non-conservative forces is not reversible, even if the path is exactly reverse. Though the path is exactly reverse, these forces are not reversible. These non-conservative forces are not reversible. So this will be regarding conservative and non-conservative forces. So in short, in case of conservative forces, the work done is independent of the path followed by the object, and in case of non-conservative forces, the work done depends upon the path followed by that object during its motion. And now let us see work done by a variable force. Work done by a variable force. The variable force is nothing but the force which continuously changes in its magnitude and direction. If the magnitude as well as the direction of the force changes continuously, that is point to point, then such type of force is called as variable force. And therefore, now let us see the work done by a variable force. Now द फॉर्मूला फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग वर्क डन इज गिवन एज वी नो दैट फॉर्मूला दैट इज वर्क डन डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू फैक्टर एफ डॉट फैक्टर एस एज इट इज स्केलर प्रोडक्ट ऑफ एफ एंड एस इट विल बी रिटर्न एज एफ एस कॉस थीटा एफ एस कॉस थीटा फिर दिस थीटा विल बी द एंगल बिटवीन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द फोर्स एंड द डायरेक्शन ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट सो थीटा इज द एंगल बिटवीन फोर्स एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट नाउ दिस फॉर्मूला एफ एस कॉस थीटा विल बी नाउ एप्लीकेबल ओनली इफ द फोर्स एफ एंड इट्स डिस्प्लेसमेंट एस बोथ एफ एंड एस आर कॉन्स्टेंट एंड फाइनाइट इफ एफ एंड एस आर कॉन्स्टेंट and finite then and then only we can use this formula to determine the work done but if the force is variable that is continuously changing in its magnitude and direction then to calculate this work done we have to consider the concept of integration by using the graphical method so The variation of force and displacement will be plotted graphically and then by using the concept of integration, we can find out the total work done. So integration is nothing but again it is the addition or summation of infinite number of quantities. And therefore, let us consider this figure in which the force is plotted along y-axis, the corresponding displacement S. is plotted along x-axis and here the force is the variable force because at each and every point along this curve the magnitude and direction of the force will continuously change and therefore we can say that the force which is acting along this curve AB is the variable force. Now the initial displacement here it is taken as S1 final displacement is taken as S2 we have to find out the total work done for this displacement S2 minus S1 so for that purpose we have to use the concept of integration and therefore we have divided this displacement from S1 to S2 into large number of small elements of the displacement and here one of the shaded strip having its displacement equal to ds that is infinitely small very very small infinitesimal displacement ds is considered first of all we will calculate the work done for this very very small displacement ds and then by integrating it we will get the total displacement here so the work done for this total displacement will be obtained by integrating the work done for this small displacement ds now if you consider very very small displacement ds then for this we can consider that the force acting here on this shaded strip will be nearly constant and therefore we can use this formula f dot s to calculate the work done and therefore for this figure consider the non-linearly varying force so here the force is not linear it is non-linearly varying and it is plotted along or against displacement s then the force and displacement are in the same direction the force and the displacement will be directed in the same direction that is along positive direction of x axis now we have to find out the work done by this force during the displacement from s1 to s2 from this figure now the displacement is divided into large number of infinitely small displacements and we have considered one such displacement ds as ds is very small the force f is practically constant and therefore for this displacement as force is constant for that shaded strip the work done dw will be given as that work done dw will be given as this formula f into s this will be f into s theta between them as their directions are same theta between them will be 0, cos 0 will be equal to 1, and only this fs will represent that small work done dw. And therefore, the total work done for the displacement s2 minus s1, that is between s1 and s2, will be obtained by taking integration of dw, and therefore we can write w is equal to, from s1 to s2, these are the limiting values of displacement dw. It will be written as w is equal to, that is total work done will be equal to integration from s1 to s2 fds, because this dw is equal to fds. Now this integration from s1 to s2 fds, it will be nothing but, this will be the area under this curve AS1S2B. Area under this curve will be nothing but the total work done. And therefore, we can say that the area under the curve from S1 to S2 gives total work done W. Now, instead of that, if the force F is linearly varying, in this case, there is a linear variation of the force from A to B. It is linearly varying. It is decreasing linearly. Again, if you plot the graph of force against displacement for this linearly varying force, then the nature of the graph will be as shown. And again, what will be the work done for the displacements between S1 and S2? So for S2 minus S1 displacement, that is from A to B point, what will be the total work done? So that total work done will be equal to the area of the trapezium AS1S2B. AS1S2B, its area, the area of this trapezium will be equal to the total work done. Again, as that of previous case, in order to find the total work done, this will be again divided into large number of small elements of this displacement, that is very very small displacements similar to that of this ds. And again, by finding out the work done, small work done for that strip ds, we can find the total work done. So in this case, if there is linear variation of the force, then work done will be equal to the area of the trapezium AS1S2B. So in this way, if the force is variable, then the work done can be calculated graphically by considering the concept of integration. And now let us see the next point, that is work energy theorem. Work energy theorem. So what is the statement of it? So two statements will be given here in order to explain this work energy theorem. So when an object is falling down from some height, there is decrease in its potential energy. We know that if any object is falling down on the ground, at that time there will be decrease in its potential energy due to the conservative force. And this decrease in potential energy is then converted into kinetic energy of that object, and the work done by the force appears as kinetic energy. When an object is falling down, there is decrease in its potential energy due to the conservative force, and this decrease in potential energy is converted into kinetic energy of that object, and the work done by the force appears as the kinetic energy. Or when an object is thrown upwards, instead of falling down, if any object is thrown upwards, if it is moving upwards, there is decrease in its kinetic energy. So when the object will be thrown in the upward direction, at that time there will be decrease in its kinetic energy, and that decrease in kinetic energy will appear as the work done against the conservative force. And therefore we can say that when an object is thrown upwards, there is decrease in its kinetic energy by an amount equal to the work done against the conservative forces. Now, in short, this theorem, work energy theorem, will be now explained by using, we have to consider here work energy theorem, and we will consider two different cases in order to explain this work energy theorem. So in the first case, we will consider that force is constant. So in the first case, consider an object of mass m which is moving with velocity u, that is the initial velocity, and it experiences a constant force F, and after that it slows down so that its velocity becomes equal to V. So we have considered here an object of mass M which is initially moving with velocity u. It is experiencing a constant force F, and due to that then it slows down and its velocity becomes, that is final velocity, equal to V. Now in this case, both initial velocity and force are in the same direction. Initial velocity u and the force will be in the same direction. Then if we consider Newton's second law of motion, that is F is equal to ma, then from this acceleration A is equal to F by m. Then by using the third kinematical equation, that is V square equal to U square plus 2AS, we have, by using this relation V square equal to U square plus 2AS, if this U square is shifted towards left, it will become V square minus U square. So V square minus U square equal to 2AS. But in this case, the acceleration will be negative, that is A will be minus A. And therefore, as velocity is now decreasing, that body is slowing down, therefore negative acceleration will be there, retardation of that body will be there, and therefore A will be taken as negative. And therefore we can write V square minus U square equal to 2 into minus AS. V square minus U square equal to 2 into minus AS. Now, multiplying throughout by m by 2, we will get. Now, for all these three terms, we will multiply it by m by 2. Therefore, for first term, we will get m V square by 2. For second term, we will get minus m U square by 2. That will be equal to 2 into minus AS into m by 2. So again it is multiplied by m by 2. 2 will get cancelled, and therefore it will be equal to m into minus AS. But ma is nothing but f. F is equal to ma, and therefore it will be minus f into s. Minus f into s, that is Fs. So this will give us the work done. But if you consider this quantity, it is half mv square, it is half mu square. Half mu square, that will be final kinetic energy. Half mu square will be initial kinetic energy. And mv square by 2 minus mu square by 2 will represent change in kinetic energy. And therefore, now here we will write, as this is minus term, this is also minus. Now I will change the signs. So plus term will become minus, minus will become plus, and therefore we will get m u square by 2 minus m v square by 2 equal to Fs. That is, this will be the initial kinetic energy, this will be the final kinetic energy, and so difference between them will represent change in kinetic energy. because here u will be greater than v as that body slows down. Initial velocity will be larger as compared with final velocity, and therefore we have considered here initial kinetic energy minus final kinetic energy, that will be equal to work done. It is in good agreement with the work energy theorem, that is change in kinetic energy will appear as work done. And therefore we can write change in kinetic energy, change in kinetic energy is equal to work done. So change in kinetic energy of that body will appear as the work done. Now let us consider the second case. So in the second case we will consider the accelerating conservative force acting along with a retarding non-conservative force. Accelerating conservative force acting along with a retarding non-conservative force, similar to that of the example of conservative and non-conservative forces. In case of conservative forces, we have considered only gravitational force, but in the second case of non-conservative forces, we considered the air resistance as the non-conservative force along with the conservative force, that is gravitational force. So in this case, second case, we will consider accelerating the conservative force acting along with the retarding non-conservative force. So when an object is dropped from some point at some height h, an object dropped from some point at height h falls down through air. So we have considered here an object which is falling down through air through some height h. While coming down, the potential energy of that object decreases and equal amount of work is done. When that object is falling down, its potential energy will decrease as height decreases, and therefore an equal amount of work done will appear there. Some part of work is used in overcoming the air resistance. Some part of this work done will be used to overcome the air resistance, that is non-conservative force, and then the part of energy which is used to overcome this air resistance will now appear in the form of heat energy or sound energy. The part of energy will appear in the form of heat, sound, etc. And therefore, we can say that by work energy theorem, we can write, by using work energy theorem, we can write the formula here, that is change in potential energy, that is delta PE, is equal to change in kinetic energy delta KE plus work done in order to overcome air resistance. So change in potential energy will get converted into, some part of it will get converted into kinetic energy, and remaining part will be used to overcome the air resistance in the form of work done. And therefore delta PE will be equal to delta KE plus W air resistance, that is work done for the air resistance. That is, we can say that this delta PE will represent decrease in gravitational potential energy, because that body is moving in the downward direction, therefore it will possess gravitational potential energy, and there will be decrease in its gravitational potential energy will appear in the form of increase in kinetic energy plus work done against the non-conservative force. So this will be regarding the explanation of work energy theorem.